This is Micheal Fields' the policy internships. Mm-hmm. We started them about 6 years ago. The purpose was that for years I thought, I have to do all this federal policy work and state policy work. I felt remiss in not making it available to people who would be interested in coming into the policy world. And I felt like for years that I ought to use this process as a means of helping people get career positions, get the training they need, the understanding they need, and then have a commitment on my part to help them find positions to build leadership in the sustainable ag movement. Mm-hmm. Optimally, diverse leadership. This has been very hard. But what we do is they start in mid-January. We spend three mornings, intense mornings, during an orientation. It's a pretty structured orientation. It feels a bit like a download, I'm sorry to say. It's kind of like explaining basic concepts of appropriations and authorizations and how, you know, legislators work, all sorts of things, group dynamics, organizational movement dynamics, this and that. And then we begin with a whole task list of possible things. They pick their things that are really important to them. Of course, we're in the middle of the appropriations campaign. They always help me with that. And then I get them to a lot of conferences. One of my interns is here. I always work to get them here. The other one's working on her master's, her defense right now and can't come. But they usually, this first year, both of my interns didn't come. They almost always come. Get them to the Moses Conference and two or three other events that are important events so that they meet people. I'm wanting them to network. They each spend 2 weeks at the NSAC office in Washington. Mm-hmm. I pay for them to be there, board and all that, so that they have an experience of really working. I make it possible for them to work for another organization just to give them more contacts so that other people can see their work. They have a chance to, especially, for example, one of my interns last year really ultimately wants to work in the southeastern part of the U.S., so I arranged for them to do work with Rafi and so forth. When Bridget Holcomb, who now is my associate policy director, who went off to Illinois Stewardship Alliance for a couple years as policy director, then I pulled her back. When she was intern, I had her working with Lonnie Kemp in Minnesota, because ultimately Bridget said she wanted me moving back to Minnesota. Mm-hmm. So that's, I work, allow right. people to work for other groups, but on my nickel. Mm-hmm. But I want them to get that expertise. And then I help them find jobs.
Great.
And so currently Kara Slaughter, who's the intern who's here, she's ending her internship early. She's starting, her new job is she's the Wisconsin Farmers Union government relations representative. Is
Excellent.
That cool?
Yeah.
Yeah, but Steph, you probably know Steph Larson. Before she was Community Food Security, she was my intern.
Oh, really?
Helped her get that position with Community Food Security and with Center for Rural Affairs. I have to say, I write letters of recommendation for years.
Yeah,
for interns.
And how do they find out more about the internship? Or?
I announce it in September.
Okay.
I usually, mid-September is when I send it out, pass the word. Mm-hmm. And then I have a network of people to whom I send it out. You will soon be on it.
Okay.
And then I ask, applications are usually due essentially the end of October. So I give it about 6 weeks. Mm-hmm. And then I try to get back to people by mid-November so that people who are in school or whatever can begin to make their changes that they need to make to get here.
Okay.
Because I require people to be in Madison, have their own housing, and have access to a computer.
Uh-huh. And is there a description of the internship on the website, the Micheal Fields?
Probably so, but I would be glad to send you a copy if there's not.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
On the website, we actually have a lot of we have a lot of the interns that we've had in the past giving current updates on what they're doing.
Okay. And that, again, is Micheal Fields Agricultural Institute.
Exactly.
Excellent. Thanks.
Thank you. That's great. It's a good idea.
Yeah.
And so, the top criterion for me is that a person is clear about their career intention in going into sustainable agriculture policy. Mm-hmm. I say to people, I put a huge amount of my time, effort, and money into it, and so I'm not willing to have it be the explore the world kind of internship, which Micheal Fields has some of those too, but not this one.
Okay.
This is about helping people build the movement very specifically as policy people.
Right. Okay.
And so the criterion that is the single most important for me is their clarity of intention with regard to their career.
Mm-hmm.
And I have really experienced that. Bridget's the one exception to this. She was an undergraduate, but she was a 26-year-old undergraduate who had taken some time off before. Most undergraduates aren't clear and frankly shouldn't be. You know, they're still, I hope, exploring. Yeah. And I don't really want to short-circuit that. Mm. So I will say that my experience is that people who are a little older mm-hmm. have experienced more things and have made more choices and have a more refined sense of paths not taken and paths they do wish to take. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. a better choice, because my pool is people who are clear.
Right. Yeah. Excellent.
Thank you very
Thanks.
Much.
Thanks.
No, thank you.